Great time in Rarotonga. It was good to see a different island and different people. One of the things that I noticed when I was there, wherever you go in the world, people are people. And yes, there is a Pacific Island time, and there's a New Zealand kind of time. And We were always amused by the instructions. You know, the bus comes every hour. And of course, it depends how you interpret the hour. It can be anything from 10 past, 15 past, 20 past. And one time, it came at 10 to. It went early, so we missed that one. What is the time? Hence my topic today. But the more I think about time, the more I realize it's actually quite deep time. I don't have the time to go into details this morning, but familiar scripture that we've seen many a times, to everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven. So yeah, for this morning, I thought we would just look at this topic. To everything, there is a season, a time for everything under heaven. Everything has a season. Everything has a season. How many things that have seasons? It's literally everything. Anything you call a thing, it has a season, which means, this is good news for, hopefully for everyone, that no season lasts forever. You may have noticed that already in life. The older you get, the more you realize things have changed, and they continue to change. As you know, we have 10 children. There was one point we had, was it 4 under 5 or 4 under 6? And Sandra was very tired. And I used to say this to her, it's only for a season. And at that time, it seemed like forever when you change nappies. In those days, cloth nappies, none of this fancy stuff they have nowadays. So, and by the time we left to go to study for the ministry, we had 6 children by then, so more nappies. But it seemed like, you know, those endless nights when you get up, feed a baby, so forth. That season is long, long gone. It's only but a memory. Because everything, in everything, there is a season. There is a season. So, if you're having a bad time, good news for you, it won't last. There is a season for everything. It doesn't come on forever. It will stop somewhere. What is the time? What's the time? To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven. Second part of that verse, it says, there is a time for every purpose under heaven. There is a time for every purpose. So not only there is a season, but there is actually a time or a purpose attached to that season. Every time given has a purpose to be fulfilled within a time frame. Born for a time, born for a purpose. This tells us you better discover your purpose and go for it, because time is a tiny, tiny wee slice of eternity, and time is limited. Maybe you've never actually heard me preach on this angle before about time, but the more I think about it, the more I realize every single person on earth has the same time, same clock. The richest person in the world has 24 hours, and so is the beggar. It's the commodity to all of us. Time. Time. And to that time is attached a purpose. Do you know your time? Do you know your purpose? Because to everything there is a season and a time. God created time but does not live in it. Remember what Peter says? 1,000 years is like one day. That's because he doesn't live in it. He puts us into this slice of eternity, and he sees the beginning from an end to an end. That's why it's called the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and end. And further down is this verse, verse 11. He has made everything beautiful in its time. Remember reading that? Did you know that the word beautiful in Hebrew means mature? Everything, he makes everything matures in its own time. We are on borrowed time because we have a purpose to do something within that time. And the verse also says he has put eternity in people's hearts, in their hearts, except that no one can find out the work that God does from beginning to end. Do you ever wonder why you kind of intuitively know that there must be more than what we have now? There is an inborn longing within a human heart, human spirit. Especially when you're going through some struggles, you say to yourself, there must be more than this. The reason why you're sensing that, you're finding that, is because of this eternity thing. Within the human being, God has placed eternity. And it says we have no idea what it's up to, No eye has seen, no ear has heard of what the Lord has done for those who love him. To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven. He has made everything mature in its time, and he has put eternity in their hearts, except that no one can find out the work that God does from beginning to end. You will never find in the Bible the phrase, "How old are you?" You see, because God is not into the time frame thing. But you will find a phrase that says something like, "Well done, good and faithful servant." It's all got to do with what you've done, what I've done with the time, with the purpose. So, it begs the question, how do I find out about my purpose of life? Which is a very good question. I will answer that sometime, maybe next year. Just for now, though, you've heard me preaching about the scripture I'm about to bring up, of why I love praying the Bible. You see, if God has made us, and has written all of this for us, and this is his manual for living, it tells us in here how you get your purpose, how to fulfill your purpose, how to live a successful life. Joshua 1 verse 8, a very well-known verse. Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth, but sure to be meditating in it day and night, so that your ways will be prosperous and successful. So how to be prosperous and successful? It says meditate in this. Why? Because there is a time and a season for you to be on earth. So, going from the time frame, the season we're living in, and my word of encouragement to all of us before I go to this next scripture, a slight shift, is that to realize which season you're in your life. It's interesting that time manifests itself in seasons. Got winter, summer, fall, spring, and yet that's a year. Manifest in seasons. Time manifests in seasons. And you would notice that when it's summertime, you don't wear your massive big jacket and woolly clothing. You always flow with the season accordingly. Know the season and flow with the season. There's a time attached to it. This prayer here is a prayer that I have been meditating on for, goodness knows, probably 5 years now, that I have memorized these verses. The prayer was prayed by Paul for the Ephesians. But I realized that if it was a prayer for the Ephesians, it would be good for any believers, for any born-again believers. So I started to meditate on these verses. And it's quite interesting because when we're talking about the time frame we're living in, knowing where we are living, this prayer is quite a powerful prayer where he says that may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of God, in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened. Well, how have I gone? Yeah, being enlightened, that you may know, look at this, what is the hope of his calling? What is the hope of his calling and what are the riches of the inheritance in the saints. A very, very powerful prayer. But the reason why I said I've turned this into a prayer, because when you look at it, it says that may God, who created you in the time frame, given you a purpose. You see, eternity is forever, and time is a slice of that foreverness that's been given to you and I. The psalmist says in Psalm 90, and God has allotted 70 years, or even greater, more, and then beyond that, you go and check it out. So, if we have been given a time frame, this is a very good prayer to actually ask God. God, can you please give me this spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you, so that I may know what is the hope of your calling? Why am I here? What am I doing on earth? What is it that you have wired me accordingly to fulfill? Only me can do that, by the way. Only you can do what was given to you. That's why every person's fingerprints and all that is very unique. No person has got the same calling, same job, even though it might look similar. But there is something unique within each person. It says that the eyes of your understanding, the reason for the spirit of wisdom and revelation, so that your spiritual eyes, there is something within you that they will wake up, that you'll be able to see what it is. What was I born to do? What is my calling? And the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, or the other version says, be opened. The eyes of your heart be opened. What for? That you may know what is the hope of his calling. What is the hope of his calling? The calling upon your life has got hope on it. Hope is always futuristic. There are things that are still to come that you haven't experienced yet. And what are the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints? That's tonight's message and next week. The riches of his glory in Christ Jesus. You see the announcement that was given by the angels. Peace on earth. If you look it up, it actually says peace towards men, towards people. Why is that? The announcement in Christmas time is that the war is over. The war is over. The war with sin is over. Here comes the solution that it's going to be here forever. So that's what that verse is talking about. What Jesus has paid for is extremely rich. It says unsearchable riches of Christ. Paul describes it. So pray that. I ask that and pray that you'll be praying this on a daily basis. That his spirit of wisdom and revelation to give you every morning you wake up. Father, I ask for the spirit of wisdom and revelation in your knowledge, because God's knowledge is unlimited, way beyond any of us. I also want to have these eyes, internal eyes of mine, to be open, Lord. In other words, to open your heart and your mind. There are times when you all of a sudden you know things and you don't know why you know those things. You just know it. That's a spiritual eyes picking it up. And the next verses of the same scripture. And what is the exceeding greatness of his power towards us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him on his right hand in the heavenly places. So, far above all principality, power, and might, dominion, above every name that's named, not only in this age, but that which is to come. Can you see what, if you want to know what God has given for you to do, and you pray this prayer, I believe little by little, those revelations will come to you. What is the exceeding greatness of his power towards us who believe? Who believe? Not wishing, but believing. I told you the difference between not knowing and then knowing. When the Lord called me to go to the ministry, and then when he talked to me in 2009 that he wanted me to heal the sick, to bring signs and wonders, and the difference, there was a great decisive difference between not knowing and knowing, because from that point to this point, when I pray for people, there is 100% expectancy to see miracle signs and wonders, and they have happened. Walk in your calling, work in your purpose. And by the way, the purpose and the time that's been given to you is actually for service. It's to serve other people, whatever it is that God has given you. If you're a mechanic, obviously you're supposed to fix cars for people. And one of the good things about knowing the calling of God upon your life, the phrase is, there's no struggle, but that's a simplification of what I'm trying to say. When you live within the calling of God, you know you're living in the calling of God. There is a, like his favor and his anointing is upon what you do. Yes, there are struggles in life that come your way, but when those struggles come and this purpose is deeply embedded within you, you can rise up, you can challenge them, and you can win. It says, what is the exceeding greatness of his power? His power towards the people who believe in the Bible, whatever verse that you're standing for, is an amazing power. And the power is promised to believers. Not those who are wishing it is true, but those who believe it is true, whatever the verse it is. So you're asking God in the spirit of wisdom and revelation, eyes of understanding being opened, that you will know what the hope of his calling, and then what are the riches of the glory of the inheritance. Apparently Jesus paid for things that he's supposed to has given to believers, given to you and I. And then that verse is, that power that flows to you when you believe is amazing power. The very same power that he used to raise Christ from the dead and seated him on his right hand is available to you and I. It's an amazing power. So we started with time. Do you know the time you're living in? Do you know the purpose of your life? And we now have the prayer of asking God, please God, reveal, show me. Far above principality and power and might, this is the whole spiritual realm thing. You can trump them at any time when you're walking within your calling of what God has given you. And he put all things under his feet and gave him to be head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. That is an exciting declaration. God has put all things under Jesus' feet. And last time I saw where my feet were, they weren't on my head. Because a lot of people think of Jesus Christ being the head of the church. And we always think, oh, well, Christ is powerful. He can do all things. You know, but I'm only in a body. But see what it says, that he put all things under his, not under his head, under his feet. Who are the feet? You and I. If you believe it. And then not only that, he gave him to be head over all things, so given to Jesus Christ, all things, and then to what? To the church. To you and I. When you know your purpose, the time frame that God has given you, and you're working towards that, the goal of life, you pray these prayers and realize that if you're a believer in Jesus Christ, this is where you are seated with Him on a daily basis. You can apply this prayer to your life. And verse 23 goes on to explain further. The church is His body, the fullness of Him who fills all in all. And that's where I want to conclude today. The reason for praying this prayer is so that you know the one who fills all in all. In other words, the one who owns everything in heaven, on earth, everywhere, has given us Jesus Christ so that when we believe in Jesus Christ, then we become His body. And part of being His body, we are seated spiritually speaking. Spiritually speaking, we are seated with Him right now, even as I'm talking, in this right hand of God in heavenly places. What for? Ruling and reigning. Walking in power. Walking in authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. You can walk in there. So as the time is ticking by, and you know that God has called you for something, you can thank Him on a daily basis. Minute by minute, hour by hour. God, thank you for giving me this lifetime on earth to fulfill your calling in my life. So, friends, families, brothers and sisters in Christ, I pray that you may be able to pray this and discover what it is that God has called you. And secondly, whatever place you are in now, it's only for a season. It won't last forever. And know that there is a time frame for you and for I. And we all have to live with that mentality. God, have I done what you have told me to do? And one of the answers to knowing your purpose is always go back to that last time when you had that ha-ha moment from the Holy Spirit revealing something to you, and ask yourself, have you done that thing that He told you to do? Because every hint, revelation from the Holy Spirit, He's pushing you towards your purpose, towards what you're supposed to do. And you know, you would know if you are walking towards that purpose or listen to other people trying to give you your purpose. But by the way, sometimes people can also tell what you're good at or what your calling is, just the way you are. Listen out for that too. For there is a time, there is a season for everything, and there is a time with a purpose for everything under heaven. Let's pray. Thank you, Father God, for your word to us this morning. Thank you for the reminder as we celebrate Christmas, the coming of your Son 2,000 years ago. He came for a purpose, Lord, so that we may live with you forever after we leave this slice of eternity. Thank you for all your gifts that you gave through Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit who lives within us. We thank you for these callings, purposes you've given us, Lord. We ask, Holy Spirit, help us to lean towards you. Help us to have obedient hearts to carry out what you've called us to do. For we are aware, Father, that our time on earth has been given a time frame to your glory and to your honor, Lord Jesus. Amen. Amen. We conclude with King of Kings. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. In the darkness we will wait, without hope or without light, till from heaven you came running, there was mercy in your eyes, to fulfill the law and prophets, to a virgin came the word, from a throne of endless glory, to a cradle in the dirt. Praise the Father.
Praise the Father.
Praise the Father.